Welcome back, everyone. So you might have noticed that things look a little bit different today. I've got this very hot, bright background and my face might look a little bit dark. And the reason is I want to show you the difference between using this Nanlite FS-300 and this Forza 500 in my main light. And right now I'm being lit with a FS-300 in a 90 centimeter parabolic softbox with one layer of diffusion and a grid. So when we come back after the intro, you'll see me lit with this Forza 500. Welcome back, everyone. If you could please like and subscribe, I would really appreciate it. I want to start off with my disclosures today, and that is that Nanlite provided me with both the FS-300 and the Forza 500. In fact, I asked them to send me the Forza 500 after I moved into this new studio, which has western-facing windows, and there's a lot of light coming in here in the afternoon, and sometimes it makes it very challenging to shoot videos here, but it does make it look cool having a pattern on the background like you see behind me. So my face right now is lit with a Forza 500 at full power in their 90 centimeter parabolic softbox with only one layer of diffusion and a grid on the front. And that grid is just there to keep the light focused on my face and it so it doesn't really, you know, bleed down onto my body and so forth. So the grid isn't terribly important though in this instance when it comes to the brightness that's hitting me here right in the face. So I wanted to find out in this test today whether or not the Forza 500 was just about two-thirds of a stop brighter than the FS-300, and so I came up with this experiment. I'm going to be using this 90 centimeter parabolic softbox. I'll also be using their standard reflector on both lights. The exposure in the room was 1/60th of a second at f1.0 at ISO 100. So in all the tests today, the Nanlite lights are greatly overpowering the ambient light. So I started off with that 90 centimeter softbox at 2 meters with both layers of diffusion inside. That's how it comes. So I figured it would be best for me to test it out in its fullest configuration. I've just found that when you take out one layer of fabric, you get vaguely about a stop more light. So at 2 meters with the 90 centimeter softbox, I had the Forza 500 there, and the exposure that I got was 1/60th of a second at f2.5 at ISO 100. I measured the distance between the wall and the softbox using a 40 inch grip arm. So you can pretty much assume that the front of the softbox is 80 inches from the wall or 2 meters, give or take a centimeter or two. Then I switched over to the FS-300 and the exposure was 1/60th of a second at f2 at ISO 100. So just as you suspected, the Forza 500 is 2/3 of a stop brighter than the FS-300. As you can see now, I've moved the light up so that the front of the softbox is 1 meter or 40 inches from the wall. And with the Forza 500, I got an exposure of 1/60th of a second at f4.5 at ISO 100. With the FS-300, my exposure was 1/60th of a second at f3.5 at 100 ISO. So the difference between the two lights was 2/3 of a stop, which is, of course, what I assume the difference would be. But before we move on, I wanted to let you know about my exclusive members-only learning platform, the Academy with John Gress. And on the Academy, you'll get access to a monthly, longer format tutorial that goes over lighting. They're longer than the videos that you'll find here on YouTube with a lot more in-depth information. And speaking of YouTube, you'll also get early access to my YouTube videos, and perhaps most importantly, you'll get access to a bi-monthly live Q&A and critique session where we can interact live on Zoom. So for more information and to sign up for a 3-day free trial, just go to johngress.com/academy. And now let's move on and see what happens when we put on the standard reflector and move the light 2 meters away from the wall. With the Forza 500, I got an exposure of 1/60th of a second at f8 at 100 ISO. And now, surprisingly, with the FS-300, I got an exposure of 1/60th of a second at f5.0 at 100 ISO. The difference between the two lights is now 1 1/3 stop. That's double the difference we were seeing with the softbox. So now there is quite a difference between the two lights when using hard light as compared to soft light. And now finally, with the light 1 meter away from the wall, with the Forza 500, my exposure was 1/60th of a second at f16 at ISO 100. That's pretty much the Sunny 16 rule, if you're familiar with that. And with the FS-300, my exposure was 1/60th of a second at f10 with ISO 100. So once again, when using hard light, the difference between the two lights was 1 1/3 stop. Anyway, guys, I hope that helped and maybe will help you make a decision between which one of these lights is right for you. If you have any questions or comments, just leave that below. Stay safe, call your mom, take care, and I'll talk to you soon.